patch 1.33 has been officially announced. What can we expect? 3 new idea groups with tons of great new policies, rebalance of the old idea groups, and of course general vision of what we can expect in the new patch. So guys, this is gonna be extremely interesting, and without further ado, let's get into this. So what does this diary say? First of all, October was pretty busy for Paradox because they were, you know, doing the hot fixes and releasing the patches, including 1.34.4. While in November there was the, yes, the Grandest Slam in Emotional Castle, where I was participating as well. But yeah, they also released EU4 on GOG, or however it is pronounced. Right now you can play EU4 not only on Steam, but also Microsoft Store, Epic Games and GOG. Something that we already knew, but Lions of the North turned out to be one of the most successful releases in the history of this game. Well, that was well deserved, guys. What next? Something that we hear pretty much every patch, reducing amount of bugs. But honestly, yeah, for the last few patches, you can really feel like playing EU4 that there are less bugs. So this is good news, there are probably more of them, not as many as there were. Also, please keep increasing stability of MP. It's more stable 1.34, but it's still not perfect. So one of the major goals for 1.35 that we can hear is reworking some of the mechanics that weren't touched for a long time. Like, for example, idea groups and policies. So we are starting with the idea rebalance, so hello there Mr. Big Boss, really happy that you're working on this. There will be 3 new idea groups introduced. Infrastructure for the admin, card for the diplo, and mercenary for all the military ideas. Most importantly, yeah, this is very early code, and we can expect these numbers and bonuses to be rebalanced and changed a lot, so do not get too attached to it. More like, I think they will be welcoming your feedback either in this comment section of this video or on the Paradox forum, because if you do it on the comment section of this video, I'm gonna make sure to include it in the next videos, you know guys. So let's start with the infrastructure ideas. The goal of it is to separate a lot of bonuses that were part of economic to make economic more focused on economy, and at the same time creating a new idea group which is more focused on infrastructure. So what you can see over here, that there will be a development cost here, and don't get mad or excited that there will be more dev cost, because this development cost is taken away from eco ideas and it will be right now in infrastructure. Then we have global prosperity growth as well as state maintenance modifier, and I think I don't have even more much feedback on this because these bonuses are balanced. Build cost, yeah, it's just construction cost 10%, very straightforward. Expand infrastructure cost -25%. For expand infrastructure, I don't think there are any sources of reducing this cost, right? Because expand infrastructure is the one that is giving you 25% dev cost. Please nerf it. As well as additional buildings. Yeah, I think this is gonna be fine. I will just... Please make sure to nerf the dev cost you're getting from expanding infrastructure. Movement speed, 20%. And envoy travel time. So... what if instead of giving a flat modifier, you make the infrastructure ideas unlock a unique building, roads? And roads could be giving us these two bonuses, movement speed, or maybe some other bonuses. For example, in our MP mod, depending what buildings you already have on the province, you're getting additional bonuses from the road. So for example, if there's a workshop ready, you get 5% production. If you have some kind of manufacturing, getting a very slight additional bonus thanks to the road. Something to consider, you know, to make it a little bit more unique than just a flat bonus. We have global autonomy, I appreciate that. Fort maintenance, very nice. Capital fort level, I'm not sure what it means. And the last one is the global allowed number of buildings. This is super strong. This is super strong, but I assume, I mean, the other bonuses in this idea group are not like overpowered, I mean, just dev cost. So maybe this is gonna be the thing that will make people choose infrastructure ideas. I would actually keep it. When we go to policies that are linked to infrastructure ideas, one feedback from me when I'm reading that, maybe if you go to the next time, just next to the each policy, with which idea group you have to combine infrastructure. Because I'm looking at bonuses, they are great, but it would be very good to have some, you know, background. Okay, if I take this together, let's say with trade, I'm gonna get this bonus. You know, it would be far better to give you more feedback. So if the construction, spinal construction 50%, that's strong, but nice. diplomatic reputation, and this is actually one of the most interesting bonuses because it's years for personal unions integrations. So you can integrate personal union after 40 years instead of 50 years, like right now in the normal gameplay. I really do appreciate and like this bonus. Global trade power and goods price modifier, I assume this is a threat. Very standard. Plus one of each development when colony is finished. Yes, for the colonial gameplay, probably with exploration. Global ship repair and sailors maintenance. Allow claims, boarding claims. It's good that we are taking bonuses that were unique in some place, like for example, this is for the age, and take it straight into ideas. So maybe you could also think about getting the Russian bonus of claiming the whole state to one of the idea groups or police. Something to consider. And then we have yearly corruption and max absolutes. Let's move to the military bonuses. Movement speed, fine. Artillery level versus fort. Plus two. Very strong. Like, really very strong. Now, if I knew with which idea it is combined, if it's with quality, I would say, oh, maybe let's make it plus one. Payaso is together with offensive. So for yeah, maybe nerfing it to plus one. Attrition for enemies plus one. Interesting. Garrison size. Yelim army professionals plus 0.2. Like in general, Yelim army professionals is very strong modifier because it just sit and do nothing and your professionals keep growing. Plus 0.2 is not very much overpowered, so it's probably fine. Army drill gain, fine. Reinforced speed. I love reinforced speed modifiers and reinforced cost. Shipbuilding time, fleet movement speeds, mercenary discipline. This is all fine. Then we have infrastructure aristocratic, monthly autonomy change in GAF capacity, infrastructure and plutocratic, provincial trade power. This is fine. Land maintenance, global monthly devastation, missionaries, and prestige per development. Yeah, this is actually very nice. And really actually matches the divine ideas. Now we move to the current ideas. There's some stuff apparently moved from religious to here, and I think it's just prestige. So when you finish the ideas, you have one of these bonuses. Yearly legitimacy or republican tradition or devotion or hoarding to meritocracy, depending of course on which type of the government you're playing. Imperial Mandate, Imperial Authority. So yeah, good for the HRE gameplay or China gameplay. Then we have Power Projection from Insats. Very good. I like it. We actually have this modifier in our mods, but it's an age modifier. All States Loyalty, yes, and this matches this. Reform Progress, very much yes. Monthly Splendor and National Focus Years Change, very nice. I think the thing that I don't like here is just the playing Prestige. Prestige equals one, so you just assume get one prestige yearly modifier, or what does it mean? Maybe we could play around to make it fun. Like, for example, make it prestige from winning wars, or prestige from wars, or maybe something more specific, because this is nice, good, and everything, but it's kinda dull. I expect something more innovative, Mr. Bigboss. Then we have reverse relations with some culture group, and reverse relations accepted culture. What does it mean? Reverse. Does it decrease or increase relations? Improve relations modifier, 0.2, okay, this is good. Then we have accept diplomatic, yes. And diplomatic upkeep, yes, this is all fine. Yes, this is the innovations I'm talking about. Max privilege slots, one. It's not like super broken because right now we have 6 slots, so it's not that often that we fill all of them and use all of them. But at the same time, in some use cases, it's gonna be very useful. So I approve this. Policies. Average monarch lifespan, very nice. And no stability also monarch there, very nice. Transit to faith, war score cost. Yeah, minus 5% means not making it much broken, but maybe 10%. You know, just to make it a little bit more useful. Production efficiency, cost of advisor, tariffs, co-creation, cost tax meta, tolerances. Absolutely, it's nothing really much broken, maybe a little bit of a boost. Cart and mill, mercenary cost, very nice. Power projection from insults, additional power projection from insults, so can I make it 125%? I totally approve it. I totally approve it, guys. Morale damage, X expansion impact, morale damage received. Yes, enemy army professionals, it's a little bit too OP, yes. Whenever people on my MP community see 0.5 EU4 professionals, I just supposed to kill me, right, for seeing this. So probably 0.2, 0.3 at max, please nerf. Special units for some is very nice, I like it. I assume that's gonna be with offensive ideas, if you're talking about the special units. Infantry cost, artillery cost, very nice. With court and aristocratic manpower. Yeah, aristocratic is much focused on manpower, so that's kind of understandable. Then we have Court and Plutocratic, so we have really a Republican tradition, Reform Progress, yes, Horde Unity, that's kind of dull, maybe something more innovative, Mr. Big Boss. And then Court and Divine is Construction Cost. So now Mercenaries. So they are in general saying that there's a plan to rework Mercenaries, mainly on how they are being distributed, and to make them more interesting, because that's my opinion, for Mercenaries. Early game, they are too overpowered. There's too many of them, and they cost too little. We can very easily in single player use them to just not spend much manpower, while in multiplayer you can use for like inting, having much over the force of troops. Then in mid game and especially in late game, they're getting absolutely useless, because they just cost far too much, and it's hard to adjust them to your combat stacks, mainly that they don't have enough artillery to siege provinces. So let's see what kind of ideas we have here. Mercenary discipline and possible condottieri plus 100%. That's interesting, but I mean, it's condottieri. I think condottieri might also need some rework because it's like barely used, I think, featuring the game right now. Mercenary cost 10%, mercenary maintenance modifier 10%, nice. Mean advisor loot amount 50%, and available loot province loot. Yes, actually, this is nice. Land morale 10%, so at least there's some actual military bonus to get with it. May lock more mechs. This is interesting. Then we have reserves organization. What does reserves organization mean? Please, I might be dumb and don't remember what it means. Mercs cost no professionals. Yes, that is a must have for the mercenary ideas. We have recover army morale speed 0.2. This is nice. And we have mercenary manpower 25%. So we pretty much have two actual military bonuses here, right? We have land morale. If I recover army morale speed 0.2, maybe just to, I'm just thinking how to make it even more useful. How about increasing the mercenaries' reinforce speed as part of these ideas? Because I think that's also one of the big issues with mercenaries, they're reinforcing slowly. So, you know, if these are mercs, they're supposed to keep fighting, increase the whole reinforcement speed. Then we move to the policies. So we have mercenary with admin, we have melee advisor cost, melee tech cost, tax condottieri, possible condottieri 100%. So you can get 200% possible condottieri. So instead of 20k, you can get 60k. That might be interesting. I don't really see it work in single player much. I don't see AI proposing me 60k of condottieri. While multiplayer, you know, most of the servers have rules about amount of the players on each side and not really allowing to condottieri to be part of it. Tough guys, very tough. Then we have harsh treatment cost, nice. Rebel suppression efficiency, 100%. Okay, so you need twice less troops to suppress the rebels. I actually love it. Is it part of humanist ideas? I love these bonuses. I love it. Mercenary discipline, missionary strength, morale of armies. Recover army morale, force march, cost no power. This is great. I love it. Mercenary and deep group policies. We have merc cost. Yes, some more merc cost, especially in late game. I think how the merc cost is being calculated, it also might need some rebalance, making a little bit more expensive early game, and far less expensive late game, and especially in late game, they might need a rework on the stack setup. Like, it's not like random, I don't know, 21-1-2, but stacks that are more focused on like calf only, infantry only, or 20-0-10 to make it in, you know, just at least make it on level 2 forts usable, you know, this kind of stuff. What you then have? 4 spy detection, 4 defense, diplomatic relations, light ship, ship trade power, privateer, artisan when loaded on ships, interesting. Ship cost, marines, force limit, vassal force limit contribution, and can create client states. I love it. What else do we have? Tweaks on the other ideas. Religious is losing the stab cost modifier and is getting religious unity instead. And instead of religious unity, humanists will have max turns of heavens and heretics instead. So we are switching this a little bit. I think it's a good idea. Admin ideas, all of the Merc stuff is removed from admin ideas. You remember, admin ideas were like half Merc ideas in the past. So what do we get now? Instead of Merc costs, there will be admin advisor costs. Instead of Merc maintenance, there will be max promoted cultures and promote culture costs. This is nice, very nice. Instead of interest, there will be religious stability cost modifier, OF interest. And instead of Merc manpower, there will be state's gathering cost. Oh, state's gathering cost is really nice and strong. Bonus. Just don't make it overpowered, please. Economic ideas. Remove construction costs and replace with 25% gold inflation and gold depletion chance. Maybe a niche change, but you know, in the past you're already taking eco, especially if you're producing a lot of gold, just, you know, this reduce inflation bonus. So yes, I think it's good when there's a niche in like one of the slots of the ideas, because it's focused on an actually important niche for a lot of players and gameplays, because you often go and focus on getting a gold mine fast. And I have increased interest to 1 instead of 0.5. Okay, no, please don't. No, don't make it 1. Either keep it 0.5 and move it to somewhere else. Yeah, I would just say move it to somewhere else. Well, maybe make a policy between echo and something. Something that people are not picking much. Then we have removed monthly autonomy and replaced with minus 25% reduced inflation cost and minus 33% autonomy change cooldown. This part is cool. This part, so to reduce inflation cost, maybe make it slightly stronger, 33%. Why not make both 33%? Remove development cost and replace with 10% goods price modifier. That's a huge nerf to Echo. And with these changes, I'm a little bit afraid you might make Echo maybe not useless, because you still get policy of the discipline and you get the policy of artillery compatibility. So people will probably still be picking it for these two bonuses, but besides that, it might be a little bit too little of bonuses. Maybe try thinking about something more innovative than just 10% goods plus modifier. I don't have any ideas right now. I'll probably need to think more about it. Guys, maybe you let me in comments what kind of innovative bonus could be as an ender for economic ideas. There's definitely a lot of stuff that could be added. Something innovative. Maybe a bonus that is somewhere else, very unique. Maybe... Oh, I have it. I mean... It might be a bit strong, but I'll just tell you what kind of ideas I'm thinking about. There is a mission in Mutapa mission tree, very overpowered, that is giving you a development if you build a building of a certain type, like a military, etc, etc. So maybe, if it was already linked to death cost, maybe make it each time you build a manufactory in a province. I mean, and of course it's unique, you can get only it once. When you destroy, you lose the development, but each time you finish a manufacturing in a province, you get plus 1 random death, or plus 1 production. Plus 1 production. Think about it. Some kind of innovative ideas like this. So yeah, of course, it's about the whole goal, that breathing new fresh air into the ideas. I love it. Please do it. There were some reworks of the ideas for this 9 years, but not on that level. I absolutely love it, especially the policies, because policies were very stagnant for a long time. There'll be also special events, of course, added to all 3 idea groups. So I'm looking for the list of them, because here's just some, you know, basic stuff. And that's pretty much it. So guys, as it's mentioned even here, please give feedback, both on my thoughts and the thoughts of Big Boss here on this dev diary, because I love the direction. Definitely it's not finalist, because it's an early stage, but the more innovative stuff gets there, not like plus 1 yearly prestige, the more happy I'll be. Because that's what I like about your job, guys, lately. You do a lot of innovative stuff and bonuses that are being added to the game. Please keep up. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. Remember to leave a like on this video to get it supported, to spread it to more people, and subscribe to the channel to get notified about the next dev diary. For today, that's my daughter. For today, thank you so much for watching, and I'm gonna see you very, very soon.